Hi, my name is Jerry Ho. I'm the Associate Conductor for the Atlanta Symphony Orchestra, and it's a great pleasure to be joined with Sarah Gibson, composer of the piece Warp and Weft. Sarah, welcome.
Thank you. It's so great to be here.
Could you just tell us a little bit about the piece?
Sure. I saw a painting on a deck of note cards at a gift shop that grabbed my eye. And I looked on the deck of cards, and the painting was by this artist, Miriam Shapiro. And I ran home and just started, you know, going down a rabbit hole, trying to find everything that she'd ever created. And I started to just become so amazed by all the things she did in her lifetime. And one of the main things that she's known for is that she was one of the founding artists of the feminist art program at Cal Arts Institute, which is in Valencia, California, nearby to where I live in Los Angeles. And she also, with another artist, Judy Chicago, established this term called femage.
Right.
And femage, in essence, is a description or a word that's defined by art forms such as weaving, collage, sewing, decoupage, things that were traditionally done by women at the home and therefore not celebrated in art museums in the way that, say, traditional painting or anything like that was. So she created this term femage, essentially meaning female collage, where the way, for instance, she would put it into her artwork is she would maybe have a canvas and she would paint something, but then she would sew lace into the painting, or she would collage something over it, or, you know, and there's all of these textures, like literal textures and layers to her artwork. And I just found it so inspiring to celebrate women, to celebrate art, to celebrate, you know, this combination of texture and color and everything like that. And it just immediately struck me as something that I wanted to respond to musically.
And you did beautifully. It was fantastic listening to all the colors that you brought out in the orchestra as we've been rehearsing the piece this week. And just tell us a little bit about the title, Warp and Weft. Not everyone knows what exactly that means.
Right. So Warp and Weft is specifically about a loom that one would weave on. So if you're sitting at the loom, the warp goes this way and the weft goes this way. And so I was kind of thinking as the warp as vertical and the weft as horizontal. So then if you like put that up on a page of music, then warp could be vertical harmony and weft could be melody.
Okay.
And so, and the idea of weaving different ideas together, you know, that's of course a very musical term, even, you know, in essence, that I structured the piece basically about this one melody that gradually builds over the course of 14 minutes, but is interrupted by these kind of stacked chords in different sections. So the warp and weft is essentially just the form of the piece.
That's great. That's a beautiful way of putting it. And just so also, as we listen to it, you can really hear these the verticality of these pillars, and then also the horizontal melody that carries through from the beginning to the end. Going back to what you were saying before about Miriam Shapiro and sort of celebrating female art and bringing it to the forefront, how did you find that influenced you as a female composer?
In general, I'm a pretty positive person. I like thinking about the future positively and thinking about what do I want to see in the future? What do I want, you know, our community's future to be? And I think that it's part of all musicians' responsibility to think about, you know, 20, 30, 50 years from now. And we all have a say in how we can affect, you know, what the ground is going to look like in that amount of time. And so I think for me as an artist, I think about, okay, celebrating the work of women, celebrating the work of underrepresented cultures, you know, that sort of thing is very important to me. And I think about it a lot in what I'm writing, what I'm responding to, what I'm programming, you know, what I'm teaching, all of those things. And if I'm excited about it, then I hope that just some of that excitement can kind of rub off on other people that I'm around, and that can help us all just kind of keep moving forward in the correct way.
Absolutely. And it's such a reflection of where we are today, in 2022.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things that sort of we lost with the pandemic sort of in 2020 was the celebration of the 100th anniversary of the 19th Amendment,
right,
which was when women they were granted suffrage.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm so glad that we're still making the progress. But as you're saying, as we move forward in 20, 30, 40, 50 years, what that's going to look like. And hopefully the art that we produce is going to be reflective of the society that we are today, which is, you know, access for all artists and...
Absolutely. Yeah. You know, representation matters. And
absolutely,
it can change, you know, a child's seeing somebody that looks like them, you know, a young girl seeing Gemma up on the podium, they're going to instantly think, oh, I could do that, you know, and you never know who that's going to touch.
Absolutely.
You know? Thank you.
Mm-hmm.